Hi, welcome to Programming Knowledge Hub. My name is Vishal. This is the second lecture of the video tutorial series, C# Tutorials from Scratch. In this lecture, we are going to see how to read and write values to the console in C# console application. In previous lecture, we saw what is C#, the features of C#, what are the advantages of C# and what application. If you haven't seen my previous lecture, I strongly recommend you to watch the first lecture of this tutorial series and get to understand what is C#. In this lecture, we are going to cover what is console, what is console class and what are its methods, then how we can pass command line argument to the console, how we can interact with standard input and output, the console class and application practically. So what is console? A console is nothing but an operating system window. We can interact with the console by providing input values from the keyboard and print the output on the console. The command prompt in the window is also a console. Then what is a console class? Console class is defined in the system namespace. It represents the standard input, output and error streams for the console applications. It is a static class and it cannot be inherited. Also, console class has various properties like title, foreground color, background color, caps lock, buffer height, buffer width, and various methods like write, write line, read, read line, etc. Let's understand it practically. Let's go to the application. Here, first create a new application in the file, new project, select the console application, give it a name of your choice, select the location and press OK. I have already created one console application here. Now let's understand the first way we can provide the command line argument to this main method. So go click on this project, right click, go to the properties, go to the debug menu, and here you can see command line argument. So just pass the arguments. I say welcome to Programming Knowledge Hub. Okay. Save it using the control S, close. Okay. Now we want to make sure that whatever we have passed to this string array is stored in that array. So we want to print on the console what the parameters, sorry, what the arguments we have passed. So use the for loop. So don't worry if you don't know about this for loop right now. I will be uploading another video lecture to on this for loop. This is what is the functionality of for loop and how does it work right now. So don't worry. You can see here args.length. This length function calculates the length of this array. If you pass 3 arguments, then length will be 3. If you pass 4 arguments, the length will be 4. Just print whatever we have passed to this array, just print it on the console. So print it, just write it args of I, end with a semicolon, save, press Ctrl F5 to run this application. Here you see welcome to Programming Knowledge Hub. Whatever the arguments you pass to this main method are stored in the string array and printed on the console using console.writeLine statement. So these values are hard coded here. You have seen that we just hard coded it in the application and these are paste. These are printed on the console. Now what if we have to pass different arguments each time you run the application? So this is not useful because this is hard coded. So let's erase this. Let's control S, close, and here now if you pass different arguments each time you run the application, you have to fetch that argument from the standard input, that is your keyboard. Okay, so here we will fetch the same statement, same line, welcome to Programming Knowledge Hub, from the keyboard. So right here console.writeLine, enter the statement. Okay, so this file will be printed on the console as it is. Secondly, yeah, now we want to store whatever we have fetched from the standard input, the keyboard. We have to store that statement into this array. So how to store it? Same using the for loop, specify the length. Sorry, first thing we have to initialize this array. Pardon. So we have to initialize this array. Args is equal to new string of 3. 3 is the size of the array. That means we are going to pass the 3 arguments. Don't worry if you don't understand the array right now. I will upload another video tutorial describing the complete functionality of array, how it works, and how we can use it to store the elements of the same data types into the array. Now, using the for loop, store it in the array with args of I equals console dot readline. The readline method reads the next line of characters from the standard input stream. See, if you want to know what this method does, you just take your mouse over this method and the Visual Studio IntelliSense will provide you its description. Oh, here we have the error. So, let's say args.length. So, this for loop stores the arguments we passed to the command line argument, so passed to this main method in this array string, in the string array, and the next for loop will print whatever we have passed. So Ctrl S, press Ctrl F5 to run the application. So enter the statement. Welcome to Programming Knowledge Hub. Press Enter C. It printed the same what we have entered from the keyboard and store it in the string array. It printed the same statement. So this is how we can interact with the console application. We can pass the command line parameters to the console. Now let's take a look at another example. Suppose we want to pass different arguments from the keyboard. We want to pass our first name, our last name, and print it on the console. So we can do that as well. First thing, we have to declare a variable. Now what's a variable? A variable is nothing but a name given to the storage area inside in the memory. So based on the different data types, the operating system decides the size and the layout of that storage area. So I will upload another tutorial describing the complete functionality of the variable. Right now just understand that we have to store our first name and the last name in a string variable. So let's declare two variables, string first name. Simple. String is nothing but a data type of the variable. It tells the operating system that the first name is of type string. Second string last name. We provide the last name to the variable. Now this green line indicates that the variable is declared but it is not used yet. So let's use it now. So just print a statement on the console that enter first name. Okay. Now let's read whatever the first name we enter from the keyboard. We have to store that in this first name variable. The first name equals console dot readline. Okay, let's do the same with this, copy this line. Let's do the same with the last name. Enter last name. Last name equals console dot readline. See, the green underline is gone. Now we have to print on the console what first name and last name we have entered from the keyboard. So let's print it using the console dot write line. Now there are two different ways we can print the values on the console. First is string concatenation and the second is composite formatting. String concatenation means we join the two or more strings using the plus operator. Okay, so let's do this with the string concatenation. First name is, so in the plus sign first, first name. So this plus operator will join these two strings and print it as a one string. Let's do the same for another, for the last name. Console dot write line, last name is plus operator, last name variable. So Control S to save, press Control F5 to run the application. Enter first name. Let's say John is the first name and the last name Smith. See, it's printed. The first name is John and the last name is Smith. Okay. This is called as string concatenation. Now, if I tell you that you have to print your first name and the last name using the only one console.println statement, that means you don't have to use these two statements. You have to use only one statement. You can do this, of course. Erase it, use a string concatenation again, then plus sign, say last name is, again plus sign, last name. It will print the first name and the last name on the single line. Press Ctrl F5, enter first name John, last name Smith. See, the first name is John, last name is Smith. It is printed on the one line. So we printed this using the concatenation method, using the concatenation, string concatenation. Now let's print it using the composite formatting. Okay, so how the composite formatting works? In the console.WriteLine, in composite formatting we define the placeholder. Let's say the full name is, let's say the, for the first name is 0. This 0 in the curly brackets is the placeholder for the variable we are going to pass to this console.WriteLine method. Pass here the first name. Here we replace the plus sign with the comma operator and we define the placeholder in the double quotes only for this first name. Okay, let's run it. Control F5. Into the first name, we haven't print the last name, it will print the first name only. John is my PH. See, the first name is John, it is printed. If you want to print both names on the single line only, we can do that. Define the another placeholder, first name, comma, last name. So this 0 and 1 is nothing but a placeholder. Let's Control S, save the application. Let's Control F5 to build the application. See here, enter the first name John, the last name Smith. See, it is printed. First name is John. Oh, sorry, I am mistaken. Not just understand. Let's this here as the full name. Again, run it. John Smith. The full name is John Smith. So this is how we can interact with the console using these. Console, this console write line or various methods provided in the console class. We can interact with the console passing the command line parameters. Now let's take a look at some of the other console application methods, console class methods, just for fun. Let's say if you want to set a name for the console window that opens, you just want to set the name, a specific name. So we can do that. The console dot title. The console class has a title attribute, a title property, in which we can set the name for the console. Let's say first console application. So let's run it. Console Control F5. See, on the top you get the first console application. Instead of the specific path over here, you get the title. What the title is set in application? First console application. It is useful for better understanding. Now it has another various methods like console dot background color. This sets the background color for the console statements, like console color dot, let's say blue. Right over here, console dot write line blue background color. Okay, let's press Ctrl F5. Oh, sorry, I just pressed Ctrl F5 actually. Let's Ctrl F5. See, blue background color. You set the background color as blue. Same, you can do that with the foreground property. Console dot foreground color equals console color dot, let's say foreground color is black. Black. Okay. Let's control F5. See, you get the black color. So there are various properties and the methods are defined in that console class. You can go through that each and every method, and you can try various methods to understand better and understand the functionality of the console class. So if you like this video, please like this video, comment below this video, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it and press the bell icon to get the notification of my channel of the various tutorials. I will be uploading various tutorials related to C# programming every time. So thank you. See you in the next lecture. Bye bye.